Coming to the pharmacokinetics of metformin, it has a 50-60% bioavailability. It's absorbed mainly in the small intestine. It's not bound of plasma proteins. The maximal plasma concentration is observed 2 hours after oral dosing. It accumulates in the small of, in the walls of the small intestine, salivary glands, and kidney. Elimination half-life is around 6.2 hours, eliminated both by filtration and active tubular secretion. Now, what is the mechanism of action? Exact mechanism, not known, because there are multiple actions involved. It improves peripheral glucose disposal, mainly in the liver and skeletal muscle. Now, at the level of the liver, pancreas, and the muscle, it acts. So, at the level of the liver, there is an activation of AMP kinase. It reduces the acetyl carboxylase activity, as a result of which there is increased free fatty acid oxidation, decreased fatty liver, increases the hepatic insulin sensitivity. At the level of the pancreas, it increases insulin secretion, increases beta cell proliferation, leads to decreased glycemia. At the level of the muscle, there is an activation of AMP kinase, there is increased GLUT4 translocation and synthesis, leads to increased glucose uptake and leads to improvement in glycemia. The mean failure rate was 17% per year. Initiating it soon after diabetes diagnosis might preserve the beta cell function and prolong the effectiveness of metformin. What are the concerns? Lactic acidosis, mainly fallout of the UGDP study. Hence, use got restricted in renal failure, congestive cardiac failure, hepatic failure, and other hypoxic situation. What is PALA and MALA? So, fenformin-associated lactic acidosis and metformin-associated lactic acidosis. So, you have the creatine cut points at 1.4 milligram per day per deciliter in women and 1.5 milligram per deciliter in men. This was based on the calculated ability to remove 3 grams of metformin. The ability to comfortably remove the drug extends up to your creatinine levels of 1.82 milligram. These cut points are chosen intentionally to ensure that safety. The risk for MALA was estimated to be around 3 cases per 100,000 patient years. How to use in the renal setting?